Republican Senator Ted Cruz is very angry about how the January 6th committee hearings have made Republicans look over the last couple weeks. So he went on Sean Hannity's Fox News program this week to basically give Democrats a very good idea about how they can use these committee hearings. I know Ted Cruz didn't mean to do it, but he did it, and it's brilliant, and I like it, and here's the clip.
Now, you mentioned in the first part of your question the January 6th so-called select committee hearings. This thing is a joke. This is not a congressional hearing. So a congressional hearing is designed to be a fact-finding mission. You have opposing sides. This is a political Democratic campaign commercial. And let me just ask you this question. What would you think if you had a criminal trial and the judge said, okay, we're only going to allow the prosecutor to speak. Only the prosecution can call witnesses. The defense doesn't get to cross-examine those witnesses. And we're only going to present one side of the story. That's what Nancy Pelosi is doing.
Well, if you want to prevent it.
Because this is a campaign commercial.
So before I get into actually what a great idea that is for Democrats to do, I do want to talk for just a second about Ted Cruz's own contradictions within that short little clip. Because he starts by saying investigations are supposed to be fact-finding missions. Okay, well, this is, and you know that. And then he says, in a trial, you wouldn't allow one side to be, But you already said this was an investigation, not a trial. But we all know this is not a trial. So why would you even bring that up? Because that's irrelevant. The only thing you were trying to do was confuse the Fox News viewership into thinking that somehow the other side is supposed to be allowed to speak here. They're not. This is an investigation. Investigations, no matter what they're into, are always one-sided. I mean, that's kind of the point of investigations. These are hearings. These are congressional hearings. We've had televised hearings before. C-SPAN ran all of the Benghazi hearings. C-SPAN runs hearings every day, actually, but you had other networks that would air the Benghazi hearings, where you guys were sitting there grilling Hillary Clinton for 11 grueling hours and still got nothing. This is not out of the ordinary here, Ted, and you know it. You're just banking on the Fox News viewership not being very bright, so, you know, you think you can hoodwink them. But back to your original point, this whole thing is an ad for the Democratic Party. Hell yeah. It should be. But you know what? Let's dissect that segment line real quick, right? If you're watching these hearings, listening to what they say, watching this evidence that they're presenting, and if your takeaway from that is that, wow, this makes all Republicans look bad, well, I have bad news for you. All Republicans look bad right now. But that is basically what Ted Cruz is saying. Like, this whole thing's an ad for the Democratic Party, which means all of these hearings, of course, make all the Republicans look bad. But what is really interesting is before I had seen this clip, I had actually recorded a segment for David Pakman's show where I mentioned that the Democrats needed to start using clips from these January 6th hearings in advertisements all over the country. So it was actually quite a shock to me that both Ted Cruz and I independently came up with this same idea. So good on you, Ted. You had a great idea because I do think Democrats need to start doing that. I don't think we need to wait for campaign season. I think we need to start it now. I think we need to keep it fresh in people's minds, remind them of what was said, and of course, reach some other people who may not be watching these things live. That's what the Democratic Party needs to be doing right now. Of course, they're not. They suck at messaging. But this is an issue where the wind is at your back, folks. The public is on your side, Democrats. That is a rare position for you to be in. Take advantage of it, or watch all of this advantage fizzle away before the midterms.
Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.